Hi, I'm Charlie Popeck with Green Ideas, and this is the fourth installment of our LEED version 4 update. Today, we'll be reviewing the changes that have been made to the energy and atmosphere category within the new LEED V4 program. As we've told you in past segments, LEED V4 will focus on increasing LEED's technical rigor, expanding the market sectors able to use LEED, and will also continue to strive for simplicity in terms of usability. Remember, as we go through the LEED V4 program, the prerequisites and credits have had their language credit clarified. Some credits have been combined. Others have added credit requirements or options. Some credit requirements have been moved to another credit. Some credits have been removed and the options have been distributed among other credits. Many credits have had only the reference standard updated and no substantive changes have been made to many of the credits. So let's take a look at the LEED V4 energy and atmosphere category. The basic prerequisites and credits in this category remain the same, but there is a new prerequisite and two new credits. So let's first look at the prerequisites. The prerequisite previously called Fundamental Commissioning of the Building Energy Systems has been renamed. In LEED V4, it will be called Fundamental Commissioning and Verification. As I see it, the major changes are the added requirement for preparing an operations and maintenance plan, and the new requirement to engage a commissioning authority by the end of the design development phase. A clarification as to who can be the commissioning authority has also been added. The minimum energy performance prerequisite has had only the reference standard updated to ASHRAE 90.1-2010, but there has also been requirements added for data centers and retail-specific process load requirements. The new prerequisite is called Building Level Energy Metering, and it requires each project to be capable of measuring whole building energy use. This is much like the new water efficiency prerequisite called Building Level Water Metering. Once again, I feel that these prerequisites are extremely important as they bridge the gap between a construction-only focus and one that will start our industry thinking more about building operations and life cycle costing. The fourth prerequisite, Fundamental Refrigerant Management, has had no substantive changes. There are two new credits within the energy and atmosphere category, Advanced Energy Metering and Demand Response. The new Advanced Energy Metering credit requires all energy end uses that represent 10% or more of the total energy consumption of the building to be metered, and that the meters must be connected to the building automation system and log data at appropriate intervals. This credit is a tie-in to the new Building Level Energy Metering prerequisite, and once again, I feel that this is a key to improving post-construction operations of buildings. The second new energy and atmosphere credit is called Demand Response, and it encourages projects to design and install systems necessary to participate in a demand response system, and requires that the demand response processes are included in the commissioning scope. The on-site renewable energy credit has been renamed to renewable energy production and has added provisions for community scale renewable energy systems and has had its point scale adjusted significantly. The only credit that's been removed from the energy and atmosphere category is measurement and verification. It's been removed because the M&V infrastructure formerly included in this credit has been moved to the Building Level Energy Metering prerequisite and the Advanced Energy Metering credit. So that's it for LEED V4 changes to the energy and atmosphere category. Details about these changes can be found on the USGBC website. Please contact me at charlie@egreenideas.com if you'd like to discuss LEED V4 further or if we can help you with your project. And once again, remember that each time a new LEED version has been introduced in the past, the requirements for earning and maintaining LEED accredited professional status changes. So if your goal is to become a LEED Green Associate or LEED AP, take the exam now rather than waiting because it's only going to get harder. Green Ideas can help with one of our best-in-class online LEED exam preparation bundles. Please visit our website, greenideaseducation.com, for more information. So we'll see you again next week when we'll be exploring major changes to the materials and resources category.